Well, hello there, everyone. You talk about for telephone interviews right here, and basically that if we're going to be applying for a job, and let's just say that if it's going to be applying for a job, and a lot of times that you would enter for your login information, including an email address, and then filling out that the basic source of information, such as for a position that you're applying for, maybe the desired salary or something like that, and then a lot of times. It just seems like you come across a few steps of the page to where it's going to ask you to where that, yeah, please enter your information here or there. And then that's going to maybe require somebody to maybe call you, or if anything, it's going to inquire to where that, about what the level of education that you have, that sort of stuff. So it seems like that nowadays it's like, that whenever you're going to be, applying for a job, it's not like a board game to where like a game of Monopoly to where it can just take the game out and just move the pieces around. And I know that if we know what I'm talking about, by moving the pieces around, if you're going to maybe be the ace or king or something like that, or any particular character, and I want to know just a little bit too to where that, dating. I'm like, it's not like and if you want to kind of call it something which calls like a form of a source of connection. But, have I hear that, and I know that in case of anybody that may warrant to where that number of times that maybe you practice to where that you're going to have maybe like a teddy bear, and you're going to go out and buy a teddy bear, and let's just say that you usually see maybe to and from on here. So it's like, to and from, exactly what does that mean? And to and from, and then so if you buy a teddy bear for like a special loved one, and then want to know just a little bit too to where if you want to go ahead and describe a little bit, is kind of like maybe like a job interview. So I know that whenever you're going to be applying for a job, that if that's something that maybe you've talked to a teddy bear about, such as give me some advice about if you're going to be applying for a job, exactly what area of interest are you going to be most interested in. So I know that most job applications, as we know, that are not really going to ask you questions unless, like you say, are you good with working with kids? And then are you good with puzzles and games or something like that? That they're going to be asking you about the source of education and the source of experience and that sort of stuff. But let's say, though, that most of the time that whenever you're going to be filling out a job application, that they're going to be asking you for like contact information, especially with the phone. So I know that about how old were we whenever we got in some practice with the telephone? And I want to know, too, that you get a telephone call, and let's just say if it is related to maybe the elections or something like that. So I know that nowadays it sure seems like to where long distance may not be no problem whenever it comes to making a phone call, or maybe if it's taken care of maybe for insurance or something like that. But let's just say that with telephone that you're talking on the phone, and then it could be something important, maybe related to maybe taxes, or if it's insurance, or maybe if it's applying for a job. So they got a lot of these apps, and they got a lot of the online applications to where they say that you will have somebody call or if anything go over your information, and so it's like I guess if how you want to describe it is to where that you're able to talk to an actual agent who's willing to discuss with you about future plans and for where you're at now and then for where you plan on going. And but I tell you one thing, though, that I know that with most job applications, though, that a lot of things that maybe that I know I have seen on those job applications, that sometimes it seems like that the most common is to where, do you have a driver's license, that source of information. But a lot of the information that they do ask for is a cover letter. Yeah, it's a cover letter. Resume, job resume, and a cover letter. And these cover letters don't always have to be in Word document or PDF file document. They can also, be in like what you call maybe three sentences explaining about who you are and why you want the position, and then, why should we hire, why should you be second or third in line or something like that. But I know that in case of anybody that may want to, just a little bit to word it, if you were to go ahead and design like a cover letter, though, and I have kind of like an example, more likely if you want kind of like a contract. And I know that there are some jobs out there that say that as to where, if you want to describe it, it's like more like a contract agreement. So you have right here, I put this together right here as a like kind of like an example, but still, otherwise it would have like the company's name and the position that you're applying for, those sorts of details. But still, though, that ways of how we want to describe a contract, and it basically means is that, yeah, when we hire you on the job, it could maybe be the car dealership or somewhere, or for a certain company, that they want you to at least be there and at least you to finish up with the project. So if they assign a project or work to you, and let's just say that if it takes maybe a few weeks just to be able to get the job done. So it seems like that nowadays that with a lot of these jobs that they're going to ask you to sign a form stating to where you agree and about the responsibilities about the job. So yeah, that I know that if you're going to be applying for a job, maybe not only a phone call or maybe an email, but then also that they're going to maybe tell you about a few things that maybe you're just not quite used to. And one of those is going to be like, yeah, besides getting there on time, it's also going to be about, you know, for what the type of duties, you know, responsibilities and duties. So if we can see this right here, and I know that if people can really read it, but yeah, that this right here, you know, I can, you know, use this maybe kind of like an example of a, of an application, but and also like a contract agreement. So it's like that anything that is related to about that, yeah, in case if the company needs to reach you for any reason at all to talk to you about something going, you know, about a project or something like that. But still, that in case if somebody will warrant to work, that, you know, how you describe this applying for a job compared to shopping, and you know that, you know, is can we really describe it as the same thing as buying a teddy bear for a loved one? And I guess if you want to kind of call us to where having a job, I guess if you want to say that, you know, yeah, that you know, having a job, you know, maybe a, you know, babysitting job or something like that. But really though, that to and from, if we can maybe describe it as to where it's maybe a little bit the same thing, maybe a little bit different. And you say that, oh, it's a lot different, because whenever you, if you actually get hired for the job and then knowing about all the tasks and responsibilities that you have, and let's just say that one of them is going to be about, yeah, well, you know, if you're going to be working for the daycare center, and then they say that, yeah, well, you'll be giving the kids baths and you'll be feeding them and taking care of them in case that they get sick or something like that. But so yeah, that, you know, like the particular, you know, parenting jobs. And so I know that that whenever you first yeah, you know, for whenever you are hired for a job, it seems like that you know, yeah, that you know, whenever you you feel like that you're actually getting somewhere, but then you might realize later on too that maybe it's a job's a lot harder and a lot more difficult than maybe what you thought. But still, that really, can everything really be explained on paper? I'm like, yo, yeah, on a document. And so let's just say that if this, if there was about maybe, you know, quite a few pages long talking about the job description, and let's just say that with the job description, and even if you do include a few pictures on the front, and maybe just a little bit about your meetings, you know, if part of the job required you to go to a few of the meetings, and then maybe having to get adjusted to the time zone. It's like, say, yeah, it's a Chicago time, or maybe on the West Coast or something like that, that you can go ahead and meet up with a few managers and employees or staff there at the company. You can meet up with them online, but then of course one of them could be on the East Coast, or one of them could be Western time or Central time. And so yeah, I have to kind of get adjusted to the time zone right there. But still, talk about for promises and patience. So this right here, you know, if we could see this right here, that you know, I put this together mainly for like a example for like a contract agreement. But still, that I know that with most job applications, whenever you fill out these job applications, that they would ask you for like a lot of general information, other source of, you know, basic information. But one of those is also going to be about is, please include your email and plus your contact number, and as well as an alternate email. So yeah, a lot of that information that they ask for. And so it seems like that job applications, back during the day, that whenever you fill out a job application, like a piece of paper like this, like a little booklet right there, and they would ask about, you know, yeah, about your source of education. And then, yeah, if you're a citizen of the United States, and then plus the other source of information. But still, though, that usually they would only take about maybe 15 or maybe 20 minutes just to be able to fill it out. And a lot of times that they would ask you about your available hours, you know, your availability to where that if you had to work on a holiday or if you had to come in like on a Saturday or a Sunday, you'll just to work a couple of hours. And so they would ask you that. So I know it, whenever I first applied for one of my first jobs, is I can remember that they said that, well, we're going to need you to work on, yeah, we're really going to need you to work on weekends, like on a Saturday. So I know that whenever I did, you know, get hired for a job, that's what they told me, was is that, yeah, we're going to need you on Saturday. So that's something that they told me. And so, yeah, and sometimes that some of those jobs that they might call you to and say that, hey, you know, we need you to come in and work. And so, yeah, that I guess where really on earth are you really going to really explain about the fact about whenever you have a job sometimes that, you know, I guess if you want to kind of call it, you know, call on duty to where that, you know, response, you know, saying, you know, like, yeah, that last minute stuff that comes up. And a lot of times that there's a lot of jobs that might even say too that you'll get a bigger salary or something like that. But still, that I know that whenever you do get a job, that it seems like knowing about what the next steps are going to be. And one of those next steps is probably going to be a meeting, you know, a conference meeting. So it's like, how many of us will maybe say that, you know, if you go to those meetings, you know, those conference meetings, that if you go to those meetings and you kind of listen to them talk about stuff, but at the time that they may not even ask you any questions, that they'll just want you to listen. And a lot of times if it's meetings or if it's maybe training other clients about how, you know, how to do certain things, but still a lot of this online stuff that you have, but I mainly want to talk about right here is talk about, you know, for phone calls though. And so I know, like, you know, I also want to mention too about the phone call right here. So if we put the phone on speaker, you know, how come that you don't really hear a dial tone on a cell phone? But still, I tell you one thing, though, that a lot of times with phone calls, though, that whenever you're going to be filling out a job application, you know, online, that you go to the website, you fill out an online job application, and then a lot of times that they say, you know, maybe get a phone call or maybe get a page, you know, from the company. And, you know, say, yeah, you know, it's maybe out of state or something like that. But I guess maybe the main reason could be is as to where, if there's a particular job that you'll be the one, the first alerts you within that time in the morning. Let's just say maybe if it's from like 8 to 11 or something like that in the morning, and if there's a job opening, and they'll go ahead and call you or send you a text and saying that, hey, we got a job available, and you know, within the, you know, the area within, you know, 25 miles or so. And so whenever you apply for a job, it sure seems like that to where that whenever you're going to be applying for a job, it's not just what you call a piece of paper. It's not like something that you used to do back in the old days to where that you go in there and ask for an application. You talk to the manager. That's usually how it goes. You know, sometimes you're able to bring those job applications home and then turn it into the hiring manager. But now that they have all this online stuff, but, you know, still though that I just really think also is to where that, yeah, that verification check also and all that stuff, but really though, I think that sometimes though that they say we recommend you go ahead and just to get some more basic information about success. So yeah, that there's probably reasons to why that they have all this stuff nowadays. But I just really think too is that that one, if a cover letter is not going to be good enough, then the possibility that you'll maybe set time on your schedule later on to work and go ahead and get back to the email. Yeah, yeah. And it seems like that's almost all the time. If you're going to be applying for a job, that you have to set more time on your schedule for later on, you know, to just to be able to meet up with, you know, talk to the hiring manager and just to be able to follow up with the, you know, the emails, and as well as making sure that everything on the application is all, you know, correct and up to date. But I know that everybody can maybe say that, you know, yeah, whenever you're going to be applying for a job, that sometimes it's like, yeah, they call you, and then if they might say that, okay, if there's an opening or if there's not an opening, what your interests are. So yeah, that what you're interesting, what position that you're applying for. So it's like that, yeah, that but I know that I could probably say too that, yeah, well, if you can get on an actual, your own computer, you're from home or you're from business or maybe at the library, then that's great. But still, as long as you have access to that. But I could say too that that whenever I do apply for a job and I look at a lot of the documents, a lot of electronic documents, and if we can see that right there, everybody, that this right here will be like some images right here talking about that whenever you do get hired for a job, and then maybe people that you might meet later on, and talk about for signatures. And I know that that's I'm like, yeah, similar to maybe what a few people have seen already, but from postings. But then still, I whenever I was working on this paper right here, I was also talk about signatures, because signatures, as we know, that it's not just what you call that, it's not like a test. I know, I'm sure most of us probably know that, to where it's not like a test, to where that whenever you take a test that you put your name on the top, and then they ask you questions, and if you get so many right and wrong, right or wrong. But I tell you one thing though, that with the signature though, I show this example right here, mainly for is to where that, that you are present during the time of the meeting. So this right here will be like a, example I put together right here of talking about, if you attended a meeting or two, and kind of example of an agreement. So if we could all see this right here, that this right here will be like a kind of like a cover letter. And I guess if I can kind of describe it just a little bit, maybe like a cover letter agreement, to where whenever you write a cover letter, it's basically that you're writing information, introducing yourself for what you do, and then for what the purpose of your applying for the position for. But then also that whenever I'm looking at this right here, it's more like an agreement. So whenever you do, that's one question that maybe a lot of my hiring managers are going to maybe ask you, is to where whenever you do, whenever we hire you for the company, that we want you to guarantee that you'll be with the company for at least 6 months. So I know that they're going to probably be asking that too, to where a number of times that they may have people applying for jobs, and they say too that yeah, that we want you to, we want need to guarantee that that you'll stay on the project for a while, for at least 5 months. And so yeah, so if you're going to be applying for a job, that's maybe going to be the next question that they're going to ask you, is that if you're planning to working for the company or for the business for at least a year, for at least a year. Yep, they're going, I know. They're going to probably start saying that, besides your availability, are you going to be willing to stay with the company for at least a year? So I know 1 year seems like a long time for a lot of us, and even though whenever things do get real complicated, but I guess you could say though that that everything's quite different, compared to the bear, the teddy bear. I'm like, yeah, that whenever you cuddle up with them, but still that I just really think though this, to where other than like a box of chocolates, whenever you apply for a job, that basically means is that yeah, that they are needing of your assistance, that the company needs you, so yeah. So it's like, yep, it might be explained on paper, but still that what they're really asking for is like, yeah, the person with the knowledge, the person with the experience, just to be able to handle the job. And let's just say that if you are hired for the job, and let's just say if it's only maybe for temporarily or maybe for part-time. So really, can we really ask ourselves that question when we're hired for a job, is that really, if they keep you longer, if that's supposed to be a good thing or if that's supposed to be a bad thing about that, to where that whenever you do get a, if you do get the job or if you apply for a job, if we can maybe ask that question, to where that really though that most of the time, that they would ask you to word about yeah, at the job, of the whole purpose about the job though, that whenever you do get the job, and let's just say that if you say that you'll go ahead and do part-time work, yeah, it's only temporarily, it's only going to be going on maybe for 6 weeks. So let's just say that's going to be the first thing you're going to say, is that yeah, that I'll agree to go ahead and do the job, but only for 6 weeks. So like freelancer work. Yeah. And so whenever you're talking about freelancer work though, and so yeah, I guess those decisions, I guess, are not really, if you want to kind of call it, you finalize, is to where that, yeah, whenever you whenever you do apply for a job, that you say that you agree to where that you're going to go ahead and do the job part-time or just do a freelancer work that's only just going to be for a couple of days. And and I guess the main purpose about that whole reason is maybe going to be about just to see, you know, how well you do, you know, on during the job. And I guess you could say that not everything can really be explained on paper. And if it can, maybe you can't understand it. But, you know, still, though, that I guess by a simple phone call or maybe just by an update on an email is also going to kind of explain about, you know, for how everything was all handled about whenever you first came in there on your first day or if you just had to talk to somebody about, you know, the problems and then the situations also. So there's probably a lot of things about reasons to why that all this online application stuff is going to ask for some source of general information. And they have right here is that the phone right here, the mobile phone. So I know that a lot of stuff that they have nowadays, you know, just to apply for a job. But, you know, still, though, it seems like a lot of times that back in those days that had the maybe an application, it was only about maybe 4 or 5 pages long. But still, the best answer for that will more likely be is to where that, yeah, we want to make sure that whoever we hire, that they aren't being honest and knowing about, yeah, whenever people show up to do their jobs, that we want to make sure that they go basically your requirements. So, yep, that the abilities and the requirements as well. But I just really think, though, that besides, you know, the phone right here, that if we're going to be talking about that whenever you apply for a job, you know, even if it's insurance, even if it's insurance that you're going to have somebody that's going to be asking you questions, you know, chat online to assistant that could be able to further assist you. And so they got all this other stuff. And so, yeah, if you prefer maybe audio communication or if you prefer maybe writing to a live agent, you know, from the website, and you're like, well, learn that just a little bit too. But still, I guess, you know, either way, it seems like I guess the best ways of how companies know that they are doing business very well is knowing about how well that they're able to interact with their customers. And they say that, yeah, call us, call the number, or you can chat with the live agent, or if anything, that, you know, just fill out the application and, you know, we'll call. So yeah, a lot of these meetings and interviews, I guess if that's a whole about the part about getting to know you. Yep. And I guess the best way of how I can describe it just a little bit is to where that, yeah, whenever you have lunch with somebody that you haven't met before, how do you describe that? So yeah, if it is a job interview, if it's a job interview and you have lunch with somebody that you never met before, and so at the time that, you know, you think too is to where, okay, that really, you know, how if somebody were to ask you that, you know, do you feel comfortable having lunch or dinner with somebody that you haven't met before, or if anything that it was, you know, okay, online, but then whenever you're actually there at the location and you're actually talking to them, it's a totally different experience. But still, though, I just really think too that your information, really applying for a job, though, and I'm sure we've seen this already, you know, the study desk right there. So it's like, yep, study hall. I'm sure most of us can remember study hall, right? Study hall is that place where you get caught up with a lot of your schoolwork, you know, if you missed it during the week. But, you know, still, if you're going to be sitting at a desk like that, you know, maybe working on a job application or maybe a cover letter or maybe in a meeting with somebody, you know, talk about something important. Why know just a little bit too? You know, yeah, they recognize you just because, and not just because you were in there right around 8 o'clock, right around 8 a.m. or, you know, you were in there and you turn in your resume and they looked over your qualifications and, you know, for the job or something. Yeah, I had these files right here. And I know that one of the reasons why I use that information right there is just to know about the different files. So it's like, yeah, that if there's a zip folder and, you know, other files. But anyway, yeah, thanks for watching, everyone, and talking about for job interviews online. And yeah, that if you're going to be buying a gift for somebody and half the time that you wanted to, that you've thought of that to where that whenever you go out shopping and then you go apply for a job. And they say, is that really the same thing or is that a little bit different? I'm like, compared to having a gift card and compared to looking around and see what they have, on the store shelves. And, really that maybe if you were just going into the store, maybe just to buy toothpaste, or maybe if you were just going in there, maybe just to have your glasses cleaned, or maybe, maybe for a haircut or something like that. Or maybe if it is, maybe for, if you're going in there, maybe for milk, or maybe for juice or something like that. And going into the store, just to do shopping. And then all of a sudden, it's like you apply for a job. And then, whenever you apply for a job, and then, you apply for a job, and then you just say that, okay, this is who I am. And then, your cover letter and your resume. But still, knowing about all the basic requirements about that, and one of them is also going to maybe be about is to where, come in for a meeting and for a job interview. And then also, I can also mention too about whenever they call that they might give you a reference number. I'm like, yeah, that whenever you do get a call back, and it's possible that they'll give you a number, an ID, just if you do any, if you call them back, and if they call you, and that there might be a number that they give you, just to be able to keep that, but still that, just for reference, information about the source of information. But anyway, thanks for watching, everyone. Talk about for all my job. Anyway, application for job, but anyway, take care, everyone.